trying to prove that they belong in the RLCS, and it all comes down to this weekend. Two series wins, and you are in. So much on the line. Careers will be decided today.
Axel seems to be the only one to support Rogue. Everyone else on the desk, they really think that bread will rise to the occasion.
That was,
I'm done. Later, guys.
Okay, see ya.
You know,
for someone who is so against puns.
Well, I'm against bad puns. My puns
are
great.
You know.
My puns are great.
Yeah, no, I won't argue with that. I'm a pun advocate. But now, this is the biggest. Like last weekend, we got to see Axel Toss get the correct prediction with Cloud9 in the World Championship. Now he has a pick for Rogue.
Yeah.
The desk completely against him. And it's always tough to tell in these series in the promotion tournament because you have Rogue. They're obviously here because they were at the bottom of RLCS. Bread is here because they were at the top. But it is such a different competitive atmosphere going from the rival series to the championship series. So anything can happen in these tournaments.
I'd almost say this is a more pressure-induced weekend than Worlds. And not in the sense of like the people that are, the eyes that are on you and what you have to do to perform, because obviously I think Worlds has a lot more attention to it. But this is your chance to either finally break through, to make it up to the RLCS, or to lose the chance that you had to compete at the highest level.
Well, here it is. We'll see how game number one goes. This is a best of seven. Winner moves one series away from getting into the RLCS. Now, pass from Sathew off the backboard. Jacob is going to chase this down. Gets the demo on typical center ball. Sathew with the shot opportunity, but he just keeps possession, hits it wide. Jacob again with the it was AXB with the demo that time. So we're seeing some physical play by both squads.
Try and get them off their grind a little early. Make sure they can't get those set plays. Don't let them spread out just like this. Look at these passing plays in red already.
And Sizz, we see there a double commit. Him and Joro both going for that ball. We saw quite a few double commits from Rogue during the regular season. Now, an attack opportunity. Key touch there from Jacob. That's going to put Rogue on an attack, but quickly turned around. Sathew lobs one towards net. Jacob getting it out into the middle. AXB off the backboard again. Jacob leaves it for Sizz. Joro can't get there. Now Sathew off the backboard center ball. Sizz with the challenge. AXB ready to take that shot.
I'm a little bit worried for Rogue. Some of their defensive positioning has been shoddy. They've been close to each other, both going for the same thing. At least they were able to save themselves from double commit, but they were still positioned in the same exact location. So will we see Bread able to capitalize on this? And I'm with them. It's really funny to say this name in an exciting fashion.
I was trying to think of a Bread pun, and I didn't think of anything.
We got all day.
Yeah. Now Jacob in the corner. Taps it by one and two. Numbers advantage for Rogue. Jacob going for the bump, but typical with a big challenge there. And now the counterattack for them.
Alone?
And Jacob hustles back to make that save. And now Sizz on the counter. AXB will get back in time. Center ball. Oh no, Joro gets beat.
He's there.
Chance for Bread and Bread. They score first on an overcommit.
That was like three overcommits in a row back-to-back. I can't believe Rogue weren't able to capitalize on the first one, and vice versa. The first time Bread had the opening, Jacob narrowly making it in time. They thought that was their chance to turn it around, but they just couldn't seal the deal. And Bread, take it back.
Yeah, you hate to see that overcommit. We saw him getting baited in. But Bread doing a good job of punishing. They almost punished Rogue on that 3v1 that was quickly turned around by Typical, so Bread looking very good. Typical up off the ceiling. Now Joro finding Jacob in the middle. Jacob, that shot will be wide. AXB hits it regardless. Off the sidewall. Typical with good speed hits it downfield to Sathew. Sathew into the corner. Now Sizz trying to get this ball cleared. Puts a pass, but nobody there in the middle. Sathew is waiting for it. Now typical. Over to Joro. Sathew on the wall. Hits it down. Sizz denies the passing lane. Double commit right there. Now typical. That shot was going to be just wide, but still hit away by Joro.
The pressure continues from Bread. They got that demolition as well. You'll notice how little Rogue is actually able. Is that going to go all the way in? Is that soaring?
Oh, it's typical. Now still a chance for Sathew. AXB getting beat there by Jacob. But Sipical, another shot. Brett has been relentlessly attacking. And nobody has boost. The finish from Sathew. Brett, take the 2-0 lead.
You want to know something even that's a little bit worse? Both Sis and Joro actually had boost. One had 38, one had 65. They both had enough boost to get that, but that means they completely miscommunicated. They were unaware of who needed to go for that. They both had decent chances at it. It was still a bit difficult, but that puts Brett 2 in the lead.
And I mean, we've seen how communication issues have affected Rogue in the past. That game 5 where Jacob misheard communications, left the ball, and Rogue ended up falling. We'll see if Rogue can battle back here. But Bread, they have just been smothering Rogue.
It's really easy to forget how important it is to communicate clearly and how many times we've noticed critical mistakes for games that mean so much to teams are the reason they lose a match or an entire series.
Communication's so vital in a game that is so fast-paced. And now final minute, center ball, a bump, Sizz the shot, that's gonna be wide. Sathew will have some time and plenty of boost. Going for an air dribble. Sipical comes to help him out. AXB, they both miss. Jacob off the side, centers to Joro. Joro, that shot, the demo by Sizz, but Sizz accidentally got a piece of the ball as well, a good idea. And the follow-up, Sizz! Rogue are now within striking distance.
Finally, they're able to bring this a little bit closer. Brett getting low on boost. Really only Sathew had the boost there, but that ball was out of reach. Sizz with the striker to the top right.
Sizz, excellent hustle from him, getting that demo, trying to open up the net, and now finally getting that finish. Final 30 seconds in game one. Joro off the backboard. Sathew downfield. Sizz with a touch. AXB gets it over into the middle. Joro gets a piece of it. Counterattack opportunity. Jacob up on the wall. Sipical hits it back towards his own net, but the ball is rolling back. Joro racing to it. Final 10 seconds. And now AXB with a lot of time. Mind games won and gets it in. Brad seal this game on a heads-up play from AXB.
Out of the corner of my eye, the desk gives him a round of applause for just playing with his food. That cannot feel great for Rogue going into the next game. 2 goals up for Brad. Pretty sure that's the nail in the coffin. That's right, I said it.
That was, I was trying to think of a response.
You're trying to think of a
but
pop,
I, you know, it's, you know, that's it.
People would call us out on that. That's the first time I've actually ever said that, because I never get to call those moments.
And that was just a fantastic first game from Brett. The desk rightfully, you know, favoring them after watching game one. It was quite a dominating performance from Brett. Really, you know, only 4 shots for Rogue. Meanwhile, 9 shots for Brett.
Yeah.
And that last play by XB, that was awesome.
I mean, the passing plays are looking for each other. Rogue, again, is looking like these. It looks like they're not even in comp sometimes. It really looks like they're kind of playing solo, that they're playing in the dark. You'll see a lot of times Sizz or Joro or Jacob will challenge that ball, take it up the field, find it at mid, and then take a weak shot or pass it mid where there's no one.
And you can tell, like, and it's always a question of will they be confident coming into the series. Bread, they're trying to make it into the RLCS. All the pressure's on them. Rogue, they've got some veterans, Sizz and Jacob. But look at the calm play here by AXB in the final seconds to seal this deal. This spells good things for Brett if we see more plays like this.
I mean, being able to, it's just always so dirty. When you watch someone get done like that, you can't help but smile. Even Jacob was like, oh, rip. He saw it happen. He noticed. He knew exactly what was going on. AXB taking the positional advantage, knowing that Jacob had no choice but to challenge that. He was too far to reach it and actually get the 50-50 challenge. So instead, he knew he had to try and read the shot.
We'll see if Brett can keep it going, Carpet. Game number one going to Brett, but this is a long series, a best of 7. Can they keep it up?
And remember, with today, everyone, you effectively have to win 2, and you have an opportunity to lose 2. You get 2 lives for today.
Win 2, and you are in. Now Joro missing that ball. Sipical hitting it down into the Rogue corner, but Sigs with a clear. Sathew.
I love the way he dropped that back.
Yeah, just trying to keep possession, tapping it in his own corner. Now AXB getting challenged by Jacob. Sizz with a good touch up. Joro, he'll finish that one off. Rogue strike first.
This felt a little bit clumpy, all of them in the corner here. Jacob and Sizz working together. And I can't believe it. Sizz, or Jacob, realizing he was in way of the shot for Joro, so he just had to flip out of the way. They were very clumped up, but they were able to find the hole needed.
And Sizz, that touch was crucial.
Yeah, that was actually incredible by him.
Getting that out into the mid. So Rogue coming alive early in game one. Now
here
Joro.
These are the passing plays we're looking for.
And you know, Jacob has shooting ability. But that one almost catching Rogue out. Joro was there to stop it. Sizz, into the middle of the field, dangerous. AXB gets a touch, but Jacob, he'll be able to possess it now. Popped back up above the net. Sizz off to the corner. A miss from Sipical. Now Sathew with the center. AXB getting nice dunked challenge on by Joro off the backboard. It's going straight down, and Joro gets his second goal of the game.
This challenge from Joro, he follows it through after that flip.
Look at that
the
dunk.
Altitude. That was a beautiful dunk. Sipical not even
there's,
thinking Joro
there's
had
nothing
the
you can do. There's nothing you can do there. Yeah. If you have to drive underneath the ball and then hope it hits off your back and goes out.
I also don't think, I would have assumed that Joro would not have had the boost or speed to get there that quickly because he had to come off the wall so far, then follow that challenge as well, but he kept all his momentum, tried to stay supersonic, and it got there.
And another shot from Joro at the goal line gets saved, but Sizz finishes it off. Just a minute 30 in, Rogue already up by three.
Where was this Rogue in game one? Where was it? They're now 3-0, a minute and a half in? Bread? I don't know if they have any shots. They have zero shots to Rogue's four. And three of their shots have actually made connection.
Perhaps the beast has woken up. Joro, though, I mean, even that goal, a large part of it was Joro. Joro getting the first two goals, playing a part in this
Got
in
the
third one.
Reset.
Now Joro with a small touch. Sizz with space. Goes for the backboard play. Sipical is going to be too slow, but AXB doesn't let Sizz take the shot. Joro with full boost, getting tested there. Jacob a little slow to the ball. Sathew wins it into the corner. Jacob's going to turn on this. No boost for him, but gets it by. Follow up from Sizz. He's going to hit it off the ceiling and retreat.
Rogue, now they're playing the ball control game. They're only challenging balls. They know they can follow up. If it gets clear to their defense, you watch Joro take his time, keep it in the corner. He gathered boost, he knew he could keep with it, and he just waited for his team to come and support him. I like it.
And you even see their attempts to go for the passing lane, but now numbers advantage for Brett. Demo onto AXB, and now a big dunk there. Can he get there in time? Sipical racing back.
Ooh.
AXB gets the clear.
Matthew finds the pass. Oh,
but Sizz cuts it off. And now Jacob with the touch. Rogue going for montage plays.
There it is. There it is. I'll say it for Wave. Just Jacob thinks. This is for you. He gave me a thumbs up. That's for you, Wave Punk. 4-0.
And we're just past the halfway point. Rogue, they struggled to get one in until the final minute of game one. Now four unanswered goals. Jacob with a chance here to make it five. Joro, the drop down to Jacob, and Jacob gets denied by Sipical.
This was not foreshadowed in game one, I'll tell you that. It's looking like Bread with a team that were organized, they were calculated, they were passing the play, spreading out the field. Very impressive from them, but it seems like Rogue are starting to smother them.
Now Joro off the ceiling, and gets the follow-up. Joro with a hat trick.
We talked about his performance all season. And it was not this. His first season RLCS, and this time, it looks like he just spent the last month and a half really grinding it out. He is consistent right now.
There were a lot of question marks around Joro, and he had series where he shut up the critics. Now having a game where he's doing the same thing. Sipical going for the center to Sathew, and Sathew hits that high and wide. Sizz downfield, Jacob up to him. Sizz with the redirect, 6-0 Rogue.
Not much else to say. I don't have much for you. Brett is slowly getting just dismantled this game. They are spreading out too far. They can't challenge these. You see how many weird passes, how many long follows that Rogue has right now. Just completely untouched. No angles even being cut off. Sizz had that. He had all the time in the world for that shot. Hey, typical.
And this one, a kickoff goal in favor of Bread. A minute 15 on the clock. Right now, it looks like they just might be setting up the Brazil.
I wasn't going to say it.
I mean, it's five goals in a minute 15. At this point, you just try to make it a more competitive game and get some confidence going into game number three. Now AXB, denied by Joro. Joro clears it downfield. Sathya racing back, but he has no boost. Finally picks him up in the corner. Last minute of gameplay here in game number two. Jacob going for the challenge, no boost from him. Now Joro up, hits it out to the corner. Sathya, center ball, typical. Gets in the way. Sizz actually got in the way of that one. Sathya to the sideline. Jacob, not the greatest touch. Chance for Sipical. Sipical gets denied Joro. By Joro. Joro has been everywhere on the field.
He has seriously been performing. Even game one, the game they did not win, he was doing an incredible job. Nice read by AXB.
And the backward play, Joro, he's gonna miss that flip. It Sipical cleans it up, gets another goal on the board.
Leading into the next match, I love the speed from AXB there to get around it. Same with Sipical. They were just playing keep away until they had the perfect chance. You aren't going to miss that if you're any player, to be fair.
Brad not giving up. Trying to make this a more respectable scoreline before game three. Sathya with the challenge. Jacob. Perhaps one last chance to get another goal to pad those stats. Joro leaves it for Sipical. AXB hits
great
it up.
Pass.
Sizz with a freestyle is going to try to hit it over to Jacob. Jacob off the backboard. Joro got a piece of it, but that's it. Game number two going to Rogue.
And this, for me, is now going to answer which team has more mental fortitude, right? So Brad just got, I'll be nice, stomped. And that's me being nice.
Crushed.
There was really no challenge there.
Toasted.
So now, you got some more?
I know.
I like the toasted.
Yeah, that was.
I like you started with crushed, and you're like, oh man, that was my opportunity for a bread pun, and then you swapped to toasted.
And I got it in there.
You snuck it in, and now here I am ruining your joke.
Yeah, that's okay.
Rogue, are they going to remember that they're still against a great team that beat them in game one, or are they going to start to relax, not communicate as much, and fall apart? We've seen it happen to them throughout the season, where they'll have a couple of great games and they just can't keep it up. And I can't tell if it's because of just overconfidence or maybe just lack of ability to continue that grind and that keeping your mind on the game. And Bread, they just got hit pretty hard. Can they bounce back?
Yeah, but I mean, you look at the scoreboard, look up who's up there at the top. Achieves was talking about it, Joro.
Yeah.
Joro's the guy that Rogue really needs to step up, and he did in this game. Three goals, an assist, two saves, and five shots. He was everywhere.
Yeah.
So Rogue, can they keep, I mean, what else can you say?
Yes.
Joro.
Yes.
Joro is going to try to keep it going here, but Brett, on the other hand, I'm with you, Carpet. This is a big game. This is where momentum will start to build for Rogue, or Bread can immediately respond back to that shellacking they got in game two. And now game number three here on Neo Tokyo. Sizz with a touch. Joro taking his time. Pops it up, but Jacob couldn't go for it. AXB clearing downfield, Sathya. Now Sizz in the corner, a long clear from him. Jacob, one for the backboard pass. Sizz with the follow-up. That shot blocked by AXB.
Just barely.
Now Sipical on the counter. Joro, scary moment for him, but a shot somehow taken towards target. Joro is in a precarious a situation right there.
Too many back and forths there, and Brett slowing it down to keep control. I like that, and no way. Oh, I thought that was actually going to go in.
Sizz taking his time on that one. Now Jacob downfield. Sathya gets it by one. Sizz hitting it down, but center ball coming out. AXB turns for it. Sathya hits it off to the side. Perhaps should have left that. Now Sathya going for the backboard play. Sizz doesn't let it bounce, but Sipical still in a dangerous spot. Rogue take over possession, but shut down by Sathew.
I love the bread is making Rogue fight for control. Every little touch they can have to misdirect their opponents, to make them use boost and miss a challenge. It's really awesome to watch.
On the touchdown to Sizz, but AXB cuts it off. Joro, the last player back. And now a demo Mission from Sizz. We've seen multiple demos by Rogue. Which bread will we see? The bread from game number one that set the pace, or the bread from game two that got shut out?
Nice touch to Rogue.
Now Joro to the corner. Chance for Sathew. Sathew with a very weak shot. Follow up, Joro on the backboard. That was a golden opportunity for Brad.
Joro's out of boost. Sizz is getting low as well. He just used the
double commit.
They're all out of boost. Rogue has nothing. They have literally nothing.
And Brad still were not able to convert. And another chance for Brad gone by the wayside, but Rogue still scrambling.
Every time they grab boost, they're forced to use it all.
Sizz, center to Jacob. Jacob mishits it off to the corner, or the sideline, rather. Sipical takes possession, center ball, and a touch there. Get the ball out of danger, but Rogue still just trying to stabilize.
Finally, Joro's actually able to snag boost from their opponents. That's going to be huge to help rebalance this.
And a bread.
Great bump.
That was a good idea from Sathew, but you saw it. The bump taking him out of the play. And Joro to the sideline, leaves it for Jacob. AXB uses up all his boost to get to this ball. Sizz misses his hit, follow-up, but Joro bails Sizz out.
That means they're using boost to try and get this as well. Joro knows he needs to pass that out. Sizz will stay to keep the ball away. That was incredible. AXB having to use literally everything to get that.
Using up his boost there, the smart touch from Sizz. We saw him get a passing play off a similar touch close to the post. So Sizz doing a good job of getting those dangerous touches out to the center where his teammates can score.
As the series goes on, the plays get smarter from both of these teams.
Now Chance, Joro, a little late. Sathew, good hustle there by Sizz. And now Joro takes possession, shot blocked by Sipical. Pop up by Sizz and AXB.
That was the rest of AXB's boost. He's going to have to try and get the late flip.
He can't get Sizz! He's going to capitalize on that hit from AXB, and Rogue take the lead.
AXB tried his hardest, but he had no more boost, and Sizz, he sat and waited patiently, kind of assuming he knew what story was about to unfold the moment he realized AXB couldn't make connection. He made the shot.
And now a kickoff chance. We've seen Brad score those kickoff goals before. And Brad really has had the lion's share of the opportunities in this game to score, but still Rogue, they're ahead. Final minute. Jacob is going to get it by one. Full boost for him now. Ceiling opportunity. Just going to leave it. Joro, he's in the middle. The dunk attempt by Jacob fails. And now, counterattack opportunity. Sizz gets it by. But now, ball pinching way back. Jacob hustling. Jacob getting demoed. Center ball.
Nice.
Sathew with the shot that's too high. But a great idea from Brett.
They've still got control. Sizz has to use all his boost in a really weird angle.
And now Joro getting beat there. Now Sizz with the follow-up. A bump from Joro in net. Sizz will get the boost and bail. Jacob pops it by one. Center ball. Sipical over Joro, but Joro does get a piece of it. AXB, good control from him. Centers it out. Sizz tries to clear it. Sathew with the follow-up. Final chance for Brett, and that's going to be it. Rogue hold on in game three and get a narrow victory.
Remember, best of seven as well. They need two more to take this, so there's still plenty of time for both teams. But Rogue is coming alive. But look at how low.
It's making you scratch your head. You see game number one, Brett dominates. Game number two, Rogue dominates, putting up, six goals in that series? And now, game number three, 1-0. Scoreless for a majority of the time. And then Bread, they had twice the shots
of Rogue. Yeah, at four shots, they had twice the shots of Rogue.
Not exactly much. It's like saying it's double of one. It's not exactly a huge feat, but you saw them chasing the ball back and forth as teams collectively, really trying to make sure that they weren't giving up too much possession. A little bit of passive play, safety, right? When you see people chasing it back and forth, it's because they're like, oh, counterattack, throw the cards in, we're doing it now, and then we'll see another counterattack in return, and then it's just this like constant retreating defense and like both teams thinking they have it, right? That's how they lost that first goal.
I couldn't believe how many shots that Brett...
I was watching, too.
I was just surprised at how many opportunities Brett had that they didn't put in. Even in the closing minute, it was a beautiful pass into the middle, and I think it was Sathew that shot it high. And it was just such a good setup. They had so many good opportunities to punch in goals, and you cannot miss those shots at this level with this on the line. Getting into RLCS, can't miss those shots.
I mean, it just shows you how important consistency is. It's nothing that insane. I mean, it's insane, don't get me wrong, be able to pull that off 95% of the time. But these shots that are so difficult, they need to sink in, or else you are going to lose these series over time.
They just needed one goal to at least force overtime. They couldn't make it happen. Bread losing two straight. Rogue looking good so far. Jacob's going to have to turn for that. And he got the boost seal. Sizz hits it. Sathew pops it up. AXB is going to hit it over into the corner. No boost for Sathew, but he's still staying upfield. Flip reset, perhaps. No, Joro didn't get it. And Jacob got the boost here. He'll turn on it. Pops it up for Joro. AXB got a piece, but Joro's still able to play this one. Now Jacob, challenge attempt. Doesn't work out. Sipical hitting it downfield, but Jacob going for another touch here. Sizz just going to wait to see how AXB plays it. Ball over to Joro, center. To Jacob. Jacob misses.
I think boost management's a pretty important thing. Something that's a lot harder to see that the top teams do incredibly efficiently, but to make sure that you have as much boost as possible in any given moment.
Double commit here, Carpet. Numbers advantage. Jacob going for the double tap. Centered to Joro, and Joro cleans up Rogue. They're looking hot.
Jacob doing exactly what he needed to do. Getting to the other side
pass.
Of that. Only 10 boosts left exactly.
What a pass. I honestly was scratching my head when I saw Jacob trying to go for that play. I'm like, why is he going for a double tap here when it's a 2v1? But that worked out beautifully.
I thought he was going for the shot, which is why I was saying, what are you doing? Turns out he's more selfless than I give him credit for.
And Rogue, just like that, continue their spree. Sizz, the clear downfield. Typical. Now Joro denying that ball, but Sathew gets it out into the corner. Beats out Sizz, but gets demoed for his efforts. Chance for AXB. AXB with a wonderfully placed shot. He ties it up for Brett.
You talk about them needing the accuracy. This touch from Jacob just keeping it out of reach of Sipical, but AXB knowing he's their last effort. Jacob nearly making it while falling off the crossbar.
Threaded that between all of the defenders. Just
an
excellent shot from AXB. And Brad, they're right back into it. They can stabilize with a victory here. Now Sizz, a long shot. Sathew will get back in time. Sathew using up all his boost, gets the pass off the backboard. Sipical getting beat by Sizz there. Now AXB, full boost. Going for a solo play perhaps. Might go for the dunk. Does get a piece of it, but Sathew now taking over. Misses that ball. Joro able to clear it down. Now AXB, dunk on Sizz. Joro, AXB centers that out. Sipical is there. AXB almost getting that shot. And the follow-up from Sipical, the pressure from Brett, relentless, and they get the go-ahead goal.
I mean, this right here, this proves that this team is... They deserve or have earned that spot. They have the skill level. That passing play followed by that challenge from Sipical. Incredible from them.
So Brad now responding. And that was some good passing plays. We even saw last game great passing plays from Brad. Just not the finishing that you'd expect here. They're finishing just fine. Sathew trying to bicycle hit that. Sizz will turn. Try to retreat here. He's going to go for it. Sees Jacob on the wall. Pinch opportunity. Ooh. Didn't work out. Now Joro. Jacob. Out to the middle. AXB. Long clear downfield. Sizz. Plays it. And now Joro has to follow it up. Waits for the hit from Sipical. And now he'll retreat. Jacob. Hitting it up the side. No boost for him. He won't be able to help. Does steal that boost in the corner. Might be able to do something now. Jacob off the ceiling. Sizz, center ball. But Joro too far out of the play. Now Sipical, or Sathio on the counterattack.
Keep ball. High and out of reach.
Center ball again, AXB. Hard hit, that one's in a dangerous spot. Joro with a big touch there. Sathio was streaking in, looking to finish that. And now center ball again, Sizz. Can't get a piece of it, using up all his boosts. Double commit, but Sipical stays with it. Jacob misses his touch, but Sathio didn't have the right line. Joro popping it up. Sizz, shot opportunity, goes for the pass to Jacob instead. Jacob, the weak shot, but it's enough. Joro comes in to punch it in. He secures the goal for Rogue. We're tied up.
I am quite surprised that this shot was more than was enough, but Sathio thought that was going to come in way faster. The pass from Sizz down to Jacob, beautifully placed as well, giving him the option. Jacob didn't have the angle he wanted. I think he would have intended for that to be a little bit stronger. He had Joro in support as well, but tying it up with just under a minute left.
And just excellent team play from Rogue there, using all of the team members to get that goal. See if we're going for overtime or one can win in regulation. Whoa. Joro gets it by the final defender. Another hat trick for Joro.
The attempted demolition here from AXB, or just to challenge the ball at all, but he didn't get either of them, which left his defender in one of the worst spots possible. Sathio tried to come challenge it, but Jacob and Joro, their selfless plays will get them that go-ahead goal.
And Joro, he has been invaluable for Rogue. Three goals on two shots somehow. Over 100% shooting for him. But can Rogue hold on? Final 30 seconds. Bread mounting an attack. Sizz gets some boost here. AXB with the challenge. And a bump there. Sizz just being a nuisance, going for another bump on Sipical. Final opportunity, a good hit into the corner, it bounces up. Sizz hitting it across field, going for another touch, gets it by AXB. Sipical keeps it alive. And Sipical off the corner is not enough, and Rogue squeak by another one goal victory.
It's getting closer, and I am impressed with both of these teams, I have to say. I am thoroughly impressed with the passing plays that we're seeing out of both of these teams. It sometimes can fall apart a little bit, but to be fair, we see that from every single team. We talk about how hard consistency is in this game, but the passing plays we see from Bread, the passing plays that we see from Rogue, some of the best I've seen Rogue play in a while. It's pretty awesome to watch.
Yeah, Rogue, I mean, we've seen flashes of brilliance from them. They had multiple Game 5 losses in league play. It could have been a very different season for Rogue. But now they're here. They're in the promotion tournament. They're playing against a Bread team that went 6-1 in the rival series. Guys who have experience playing in major tournaments. This is definitely not an easy series. Rogue, you even saw the desk predictions. They were the underdog coming into this one, according to the desk.
Yeah, yeah.
And they start to wake up. But a lot of that is because of how well Joro is playing. But we're seeing team plays on both sides of the field. We saw the goal from that used every single team member, Sizz over to Jacob, Joro with the finish. Mm-hmm. We've been seeing Rogue going for those passing plays, and we've been seeing Bread going for those passing plays. It's just such a small difference between who's walking away with win and who's losing it. One shot can make the difference.
I mean, even if you looked at the shots last game, I believe Rogue only had 5 to Bread's 7. And Rogue had to have 4 or 5 saves. You know, a lot of Breads were on target. There was still a defender in the way. Maybe they needed that one more touch, that one more pass to pull out that final defender. Or sometimes accuracy's been plaguing them. We've noticed a couple of their shots have been just a bit wide when they had the opportunity to sink one in.
So we'll see if Bread can work on their accuracy. A pass off the ceiling from Sipical over to AXB that doesn't connect. And a double commit there. Sathio with a demo. Sipical might go for it himself, goes for the dish play, but Joro again on the defensive.
Sathu's actually there. AXP and Sipical both up. If they don't make this, this could be dangerous.
Now Jacob over to Sizz. Sizz, that shot, is it too high? Yes, it is, but the follow-up denied by Sathu. Big defensive play.
They gave up that opening goal. If Rogue had put that on target, Red would already be one down in this potential final game for themselves. They need to be careful.
Now Sipical hitting it downfield. Joro trying to pinch it out. Gets a follow-up. AXP up. And Jacob misses. So does Sathu. This one hard off the ceiling. Sizz isn't going to be able to get a second hit. Sipical takes over, but he misses that flip. Sizz with the demo as well. Joro down into the corner. Follow-up, passing it off the backboard. AXP getting it out of danger. Still AXP tested again. Gets a long clear. And now Jacob going for a demo on Sipical, but Sipical gets the best of him. Chance for Sathu. Sathu denied by Sizz.
Pre-jump successful in Sizz's book. Oh, and the bump!
And Sizz bumped by Sipical, and then, oh gosh, there were so many bumps in that play. I got tied up on the names, but a bump by both Brett and Rogue, like a game of chess. And now Joro gets it by.
Look at that.
Dodging demos. He runs out of boost. Sizz, center ball to Jacob. Jacob off the post. Chance for Joro. Joro denied by AXP.
Another opportunity lost from accuracy. And now Brett's here for the counterattack.
The counterattack paying off. AXP strikes first for Brett.
We've seen this all series. Counterattack followed by counterattack. Oh, my God, that pass was typical. He baited Jacob so hard for that. He forced Jacob to come out for it, delayed that flip until the last second possible, popped that mid.
I mean, we even saw Sipical. He went for that ceiling pass rather than the shot. So Sipical continuing to look for those passing lanes, finding it there in a big, big moment for Brett. Joro, the follow-up, that one sneaks by, and Rogue tie it up.
Keeping it close. 2 minutes, 38 seconds, about to be at halftime. Sizz going for the cheeky plays. That was actually a great pass.
And Jacob got the bump in net as well. Rogue firing on all cylinders, the play.
You see how risky that was, though. All three
Rogue
players.
Incredibly risky. If that shot was blocked on a 50-50,
that was it for them.
Jacob was in the net.
Another
there was no hope. But Rogue, make it work. Now AXB off his own back wall. Using up a lot of boost for that. Now Jacob is going to follow it up. Sathu gets a piece of it. Now off the backboard, Jacob pinning it into the corner, takes it over again, pops it by Sathu. Going for a dunk on AXP, got a piece. And now a miss there. Sipical and Sizz both whipping. Jacob taking his time. Trying to just be a thorn in this
great
red defense. Oh. AXB lets it bounce over and then gets bumped to oblivion. A demo from Sipical on Jacob. Now chance for Sathu off the backboard, and he misses it. And the shot's wide.
That's got to hurt so bad. That is two wide open shots.
You cannot miss shots at this level on this stage with so much on the line. Red seems to be making a little bit of a habit out of it. They need to end that now. Still in the game. Jacob!
Jacob! I can't believe it. He does it every time, no matter what. The recovery on the wall follows through. Gets just one more touch. The speed he got to that is what made it impressive. The touch was relatively textbook, but the speed he got there using that flip perfectly, well done.
And this is such a massive series. The winner is one series away from securing a spot in Season 7 of the RLCS. Losers not out of it, but still maintaining that extra life, so huge. Now Sipical, center ball.
AXP,
he misses that opportunity. Another great setup, just narrowly missed out on by Brad.
Kept it high. AXP's there for the challenge.
Brad. Mounting an attack now off the backboard. Jacob gets a piece of it.
Rogue's losing boost.
And Jacob using up everything he had. Off the backboard, Sizz does just
barely
graze that ball. Final 30 seconds. It's now or never for Bread. Pass downfield. AXB. Now Sathew over to Sipical. Sipical getting blocked by Sizz. Can Sizz get there in time? No boost for him. Jacob with the follow-up, and that's not going to find its mark.
Did they dedicate too much to this? Can Brett turn it around? No, the challenge stays from Joro.
Last chance for Brett. Sipical over to AXB. AXB getting that challenge. They can't let it touch. Sipical keeps it up. AXB up, and Jacob with a bump there takes a player out of the game, and Rogue get the ball to touch the ground. That's it. They're moving on.